produces a product, if the price of the product increases, of course the demand for that product will decrease. And the other way, when price drop, then the demand will increase. So when we have a cheaper product, then more people will be buying. If the product's price increase, then less people will demand for that product. So therefore, we have the demand function, which is represented by a gradient, a negative gradient here. Now, next, we look at the supply function. Supply function is represented by a positive gradient, and the graph will look like this, denoted by the symbol S. So in this situation, we can see that when the price increase, the price increase from here to here, all right, we see that the supply will increase because factories or suppliers, they would like to increase their production if the price is good. But if the price is not good, the price fall, then the supply of that product will decrease, all right? So the supplier would like to see a higher price, and the buyer would like to see a lower price. So therefore, in the market situation, where there will be a time where a certain price is acceptable by the buyer and also acceptable by the supplier. So this is when the situation we say the demand is equal to supply. So in this case, if we look at the demand curve denoted by D and the supply curve, the intersection point, which is represented by E, will be the market equilibrium point. At this point, the price denoted at this point will be a price where the buyer is prepared to pay and the supplier is prepared to produce that quantity for that kind of price. Okay? So in other words, the market equilibrium, all right, the market equilibrium point is obtained from the intersection point of the demand and supply curve. Okay, let's look at example 10. In example 10, we are asked to identify the following equations to determine which one is a demand or supply curve. Then after that, you're asked to find the market equilibrium point. Okay, look at this example. For P plus 2Q equals to 100, so the first step is, remember, P is represented by y-axis, Q is represented by x-axis. So in other words, P is y, Q is x. So change this first to the format y equals to mx plus c. So we shift the 2q to the right, we'll get p equals to negative 2q plus 100. So compare with y equals to mx plus c, then we have found that the gradient is actually equals to negative. So that means this equation is a demand curve or demand function. And if you look at the other equation, 3p equals to q plus 125, change this into y equals to mx plus c, we can say p equals to 103q plus 125/3, compare with y equals to mx plus c, then m is a positive, which means this is a supply curve. Okay? In order to find the market equilibrium point, we will use the what we call the substitution method. For example, P plus 2Q equals 100, let's write this as equation 1, and then 3P equals to Q plus 125, we will write this as equation 2. Right? So what we do is now we take equation 1, substitute into equation 2. So replace P with 100 minus 2Q into equation 2. So we will get 3P, which is 3 times 100 minus 2Q equals to Q plus 125. So when we simplify, we will get the value of Q equals to 25. Okay? So once we have found the value of Q, then what we do is to substitute into equation 1. So when we substitute into equation 1, we will get P equals 100 minus 2 times 25. Yeah, when we simplify, the value of P is equals to 50. Hence, the market equilibrium point is represented by QP of 25,